Where should I live in Canada? Where should I live in Canada? Sometimes people ask me this question. Well, Canada is a huge country. Okay, look how big it is. You can live anywhere you want. It's your choice. But realistically, you're going to live only in a very small area of Canada. Okay, 90% of Canada's population lives within 160 kilometers from the US border. Okay, so this is the USA down here. So 90% of Canada's population lives in a very narrow strip right down here along the border. Okay, look, all of Canada's cities are basically in a straight line from Vancouver, Calgary, Regina, Winnipeg, Toronto, Ottawa, Montreal, and Halifax. Okay, all sort of in a straight line, which is interesting because you would think the Canadian government would build a high-speed train that goes all across Canada. It would be so easy. It's just one line, just one track, all in a straight line. But we don't have a high-speed train. Why not? Well, I'm not sure. Okay, it could be that we have some really big mountains over there, okay, in Alberta and British Columbia. I mean, they're big mountains. They're called the Rocky Mountains. So maybe it's really hard to build trains and build tunnels through the mountains. I'm not sure. Okay, but you know what? Even if we had a high-speed train in Canada, I'm not sure if people would use it. I would use it because I like trains. But Canadians love to own vehicles, especially trucks. Okay, they love to drive their trucks and they drive long distances with their vehicles. You know, some people drive like 12 hours between cities every week. Okay, every week they might drive like from here to there. Okay, that's a long, long trip. Okay, now most people, if they're going long distances, they fly because to drive from, let's say, Vancouver, I'll use my teaching stick to drive from Vancouver all the way over here to Halifax. That would take like 4 or 5 days. 4 or 5 days of driving. Okay, that's a long way. So, usually, when people want to cover long distances, they just take an airplane. Okay, but traveling by airplane in Canada is really expensive. I think it's one of the most expensive countries for airfare. Okay, so that's not very good. Okay, so where should you live in Canada? Well, you have a lot of options, and it depends what you like. Okay, do you like the ocean? Then you have two options. Okay, you can live on the west coast or you can live on the east coast. Okay, now the weather over there on the west coast is pretty nice even in the winter. I mean, it's not that cold, okay? All of Canada is extremely cold in the winter, but that's the nicest place to be in the winter. So if you don't want cold weather, you should live over there. And if you like oceans, that's a great place. And over here, you get an ocean as well. Okay, now if you like mountains, you should live very close to my house here in Calgary. We have big mountains called the Rocky Mountains right here between Alberta and BC. BC means British Columbia. Okay, that province is called BC. This province is Alberta. Here is Saskatchewan, Manitoba, Ontario, Quebec, and these provinces over here are called the Maritime Provinces. Okay, so these provinces in the middle of Canada are called the Prairie Provinces. Prairie. Prairie means flat. Flat farmland. Okay, so lots of farmers live in this area. If you drive from here to here, it's just flat. all flat. You can drive for like 20 hours, 30 hours. It is just flat. You're going to see lots of fields like this, fields. You're going to see lots of bales. Okay, these things are called bales. They're for animals to eat. Okay, so if you like flat prairies, this is a good place to live. If you like lakes and forests, okay, then you should live over here. I mean, all of Canada has lots of lakes, forests, mountains, okay, but this area particularly is very nice. There's lots of lakes and there's lots of rock, okay? That's why it's called the Canadian Shield, because there's lots of rock like this, okay? A lot of nice trees. So you might want to live somewhere over here, okay? Now, if you want to learn French, or if you speak French and you want to live in the French part of Canada, then you need to live in this province here called Quebec, okay? Montreal is right there. Okay, so do you want to live in a city or a town? Well, if you live in a town, you might find that the people are more friendly, okay? And it might be easier for you to make friends. If you have a family, if you're bringing your family to Canada, a small town would be really nice. They're safer. They're just a better environment for a family. Okay, so let's take a look at a small town called Altona, Manitoba. Remember, this province is called Manitoba, and there's a small town here called Altona. Okay, this is what the town looks like from the air. Okay, now, Altona has a population of about 4,000 people. Okay, so it's pretty small. It has a shopping mall, it has a swimming pool and parks, and it's about 1 hour drive from Winnipeg. Okay, Winnipeg is the capital city of Manitoba. Okay, Winnipeg's here. Altona is about down there, closer to the border. Okay, so if you live in Winnipeg, it's going to have some advantages over living in the town of Altona. Okay, for example, in Winnipeg, there's going to be more jobs. There's going to be more immigrants. So it'll be easier for you to make friends from your own country. Okay, there's a lot of Filipino immigrants that live in Winnipeg, Indian immigrants, Chinese. Okay, there's a lot of from everywhere that live in Winnipeg. Okay, there's going to be more shopping. If you love shopping and malls and big stores, I mean, the big cities are going to have more shopping, right? There's going to be universities. Okay, small towns don't have universities. Okay, so if you're going to go to a university, well, then you need to live in a big city. Okay, so I want to know, where do you want to live in Canada? Let me know in the comments right down there. I would be happy to answer any questions you have. Maybe you're coming to Canada and you're thinking about moving to a certain place and you have some questions. I would be happy to help you. I'd be happy to answer your questions. Just leave them down there in the comments, and I'll see you over in the next episode of Mad English TV. Take care.